Hey guys, welcome back to my 100 most popular algorithm series. In this particular video, we are going to take a look at another problem, which is an array based problem. It's a LeetCode problem number 189, which is rotate array. It's a medium categorized problem and liked by close to 4000 people. The problem statement is pretty straightforward. We're given an array of numbers and we're given a step which is denoted by k. What we need to do is rotate the array that many times, k number of times. So here the k is 3. So we need to rotate this array rightwards 3 times. So 5, 6, 7 will come prior to the rest of the array. So yeah, that's it. That's the array rotation problem statement. Now, the tricky part is, can we do it in a without any extra space in O of in constant space complexity? So that is something that I'm going to attempt. So let's understand how that can be achieved first. So here I have an array, 7 elements, and here I have k, which is 3. Now the first thing that we need to do, so it's a 3-step process, but before we begin, we need to normalize k. Because see, k can be anything. It can be potentially, it can be greater than the number of the length of the array itself. So for example, if k could have been 8. So here we have 7 elements and k is 8. So we need to rotate it 8 times, which is effectively same as rotating the array one time. So we need to normalize it. We need to actually convert this into 1. Okay, because then rotating the array 8 times is same as rotating the array one time. So this will reach to this number by k mod length of the array. Right, so that is the normalizing step that we need to perform. So that is the first step. So once the k is normalized, then rotating the array in place is 3-step process. In the first step, we'll rotate the entire array. Okay, so that it will look like this after entire array rotation. Now next step is we'll rotate. So here in the earlier example, we have taken k is 3. So we'll rotate k elements, first k elements again in the second step. So I'll rotate these. So then I have 5, 6, 7 and the rest of the array at this point remains the same. And in the last step, we'll rotate the remaining elements. So here we'll rotate the remaining elements. So the first element, first k elements will remain the same and the rest of the array is rotated. So that will be like, it looks like this. So after these 3 steps, we have actually rotated the entire array like the way we want. So we have 5, 6, 7 have appeared here and the rest of the array is appended after that. So yeah, that's the logic in order to rotate this array k times and in place without any extra memory. Okay, so let's begin the coding of this problem. So here we need to check whether the array is not present or we just have 1 or 0 elements in the array, right? In that case, we know that the rotation of zero elements, the rotation of single element is the same as the array itself. So we don't really have to do anything. The next step is that we need to normalize k, as I mentioned. So because k could be potentially be greater than the length of the array. So normalization is like this. So if k is given as 8, then in after normalization k will become 1. Now it may so happen that k after the normalization has resulted into 0, which means we don't need any notation at all, right? If k is 0, we don't really need to notate anything, so we'll just return straight away because we have nothing to do. Okay, so after the normalization step, we have these 3 steps, 1, 2, 3, in order to reach to our final answer. In the first step, we need to rotate the entire array, but in place. So what I'll do like this. So I'll have this will slice the entire array, and then I'll slice it again and rotate it. So this is in Python. This means slice the entire array and reverse it. -1 denotes the reversal. So that entire array will be reversed and assigned to the actual array. Okay, Now in the next step, second step, we need to rotate the first k elements. So that's what I'll do. So this in Python will select from first 0th element to k minus 1 element. So that also I'll take that element and rotate it. So I've taken that element, first k elements, I've reversed it and assigned it to its original position. So that concludes my second step, and in the last step I need to rotate the last remaining elements. So I'll from k to the end of the array. So all the remaining elements I'll take them and reverse them. So I've taken the remaining elements, reverse them and assign them to its original location. Yeah, that's it. We've done everything in place. We don't have to return anything anyways. So yeah, that's the code that we need to write. Let's verify it. Yeah, it is working fine. So I'll just submit my code. Yeah, it was accepted. So yeah, that's the code that we need to write. I hope you liked this coding challenge. For more coding challenges like this, stay tuned to my channel. I see you in the next one. Bye.